गुड आफ्टरनून डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम प्रदीप हीरापुरे एंड गोइंग टू डिलीवर माय लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक टाइप्स ऑफ कल्चर मीडिया। सो दिस टॉपिक अगेन इंक्लूडेड इनटू द यूनिट नंबर 4। सो वी विल सी हियर हाउ मेनी डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मीडिया वी यूटिलाइज इन द माइक्रोबायोलॉजी लेबोरेटरी टू कल्चर द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म। But before going to discuss about the types of culture medium, you should know about what is actually the culture medium. But culture medium nothing but the food material or substances required for growing microorganism in laboratory, in vitro condition or outside the body is called as a culture medium. As you know that we are human beings and we consume the various types of food material for the energy production, right? So for the survival, human beings also required some food material. Likewise, whenever we try to culture the bacteria or microorganism in the laboratory, so each and every living organism require the specific food material for proper growth and survivability. So the bacteria also required the specific nutrient medium or the substances, or we can say the food material, for its proper growth, and that food material nothing but the culture medium. So dear students, when we going to discuss about the use of culture medium, it is important to grow the microorganism outside the body for the following purpose. Suppose we consider, for example, in our body there is so many different types of microorganisms, right? And each and every microorganism survive inside the body by utilizing the so many different types of nutrients from our body, or so many different types of food material from our body. But whenever we try to isolate that bacteria from our body and try to culture in a laboratory in vitro condition, so at that time we have to provide this the specific food material for that particular bacteria or for that particular microorganisms. So the culture medium utilized to identify the cause of infection from the clinical sample so that the proper treatment can be given. Means if someone infected with the microorganism, so we try to isolate that pathogenic microorganism from the human body or from the patient, and in a laboratory we culture that microorganism and try to identify which type of pathogenic organism is there, and depending upon the characteristics of that pathogenic organism, or depending upon the species of that pathogenic organism, then we prescribe the particular treatment to that particular patient. So this one is the first purpose for which we try to culture the microorganism in our laboratory. Apart from this, to study the characteristics or properties of microorganism, because you know very well in a nature there is a so many different millions of bacteria is there, millions of microorganism is there, and each and every microorganism having its own specific importance, right? Some bacteria able to produce the pigment, some bacteria able to synthesize the antibiotics, some bacteria are agriculturally important, some bacteria is help to promote the plant growth. So such type of different applications showing by the microorganism, different microorganism, and this microbial study is unexplored. So that's why the scientist and researcher focus on the microorganism, and they try to understand the structure and properties and characteristics of the microorganism. So to study about the properties as well as the characteristics of such type of microorganism, you want to culture, you want to grow that microorganisms in a laboratory, and for that purpose you required the specific culture medium. Apart from this, one another application of culture medium, that is to prepare biological products like vaccine, toxoids and antigen. Again, you have to grow the microorganism in a laboratory, and for that purpose again you required the specific nutrient medium. Why? Because there is so many different types of microorganisms, and each and every microorganism required the specific nutrient medium. That's why in this lecture we are going to discuss about the different types of nutrient medium which utilize in a microbiology laboratory to grow, to culture the various types of microbial strains. So dear students, what is actually the basic composition of culture medium? So you can see here in the slide, water, then there is a energy source, then carbon source, nitrogen source, mineral salts, and special growth factors. Already all important and essential material or elements required for the bacterial growth or microbial growth. Already we discussed in a previous lecture what are the importance of these elements in the microbial growth or in the medium. Now basically the culture media classify into the three categories based on the physical state. Okay, so there is a solid medium and semi-solid medium and liquid medium. So these are the three types of culture medium we routinely prepared in a laboratory to culture the microorganism. Solid medium, nothing but there is a requirement of solidifying agent, that is agar-agar powder, specifically when we prepared the nutrient agar medium for the bacterial growth. Sometimes some bacteria is required the semi-solid medium, so at that time you have to add the half amount or you have to add the half concentration of agar medium in the nutrient medium, and that is known as a semi-solid medium. And sometime we required the broth culture or we required the suspension culture. Means if you are interested to culture any microorganism in a liquid medium, so at that time you you prepared the liquid or liquid medium or the broth medium. And in the liquid medium there is absence of solidifying agent, that is agar-agar powder. Okay, so on the basis of physical state, the culture media classify into the three types: solid medium, semi-solid medium and liquid medium. Then dear students, second classification of the media based on the ingredients, what are the composition of media. Okay, so these are the four different types of culture medium depending upon the ingredients, composition of ingredients. So first one is the simple medium, then the complex medium, and synthetic or defined medium, and special medium. So these are the four different types of medium classified on the basis of what type of ingredient actually present in the particular specific medium. We will see one by one what is simple medium, what is complex medium, what is synthetic and defined medium, and special mediums. So classification based on the physical state, already we seen there is a three different types of medium, solid medium. So first of all we going to discuss about the what is actually the solid medium. Solid medium, nothing but the agar is the most commonly used solidifying agent. So the physically that medium is solid in state, and for the solidification, whatever the nutrient medium we prepared as per the standard composition, in that nutrient medium we additionally add the agar-agar powder as a solidifying agent, and due to the presence of agar-agar powder that medium become a solid. So what is actually the agar? Agar, nothing but the golden yellowish granular powder, and that granular powder actually prepared from the seaweed, and that agar powder not affected by the growth of bacteria. Okay, and it melts at 98 degrees Celsius and set at 42 degrees Celsius. So due to the presence of agar-agar powder, any type of mediums become a solidify medium or solid medium. Okay, and semi-solid medium, you can see in the diagrams or in the image or pictures, this one is the semi-solid medium. So basically, dear students, when we prepare the new solid agar medium, at that time we have to add the 1.5 to 2 gram in 100 ml nutrient medium. So this is the standard composition, 1.5 or 15 gram in 1000 ml. Agar powder we use 15 gram in 1000 ml. This is the standard composition. But if you want to prepare the semi-solid medium, at that time you have to reduce the concentration of agar powder. And specifically, when we prepared the semi-solid medium, at that time we have to add the 0.7 or 0.7 gram agar-agar powder in 100 ml, or we can say the 7 gram in 1000 ml nutrient medium. Okay, so if you reduce agar-agar powder concentration, so we can prepare the semi-solid medium. And specifically, this semi-solid medium we prepared in a laboratory to study about the bacterial motility and separating the motile bacteria, motile organism, from the non-motile strains. The third type is the liquid media. You can see here there is the absence of agar mediums, and totally this one is the liquid nutrient medium, and it is also known as a broth. Okay, so whenever we try to perform the new experiment, new bioassay, so before that you have to culture the bacterial strain. Okay, fresh, you required fresh bacterial culture. So for that purpose, in the first day we inoculate the small portion, small amount of bacteria in a nutrient broth and incubate at 37 degrees Celsius. And after 48 hours or 24 hours, we got there is a freshly cultured bacteria, and that freshly cultured bacteria we can use for performing the different types of bioassay, like antimicrobial activity or antiquorum sensing activity. So for that purpose we prepared the liquid media. So ultimately, now we understand, in a liquid medium there is a absence of solidifying agent, means agar agar powder. Now the dear students, classification based on the ingredients, already we seen the there is a different types of categories or class of the medium. So out of which first one is a simple media, right? So now simple medium containing the nothing but the containing the basic requirement for the bacterial growth, right? So for example, nutrient broth or nutrient agar, whenever we prepared in a laboratory, so it is a type of simple media. So nutrient broth consists of peptone, meat extract, NaCl, and 2% agar or 1.5% agar. So if you want to prepare the liquid medium, you do not add agar-agar powder, and if you want to prepare the solid agar medium, at that time you have to add 1.5 to 2% agar in a nutrient broth. You can see in this picture, this one is the solid medium, solid nutrient agar medium. Okay, so this is all about the simple medium. Simple medium nothing but the basic requirement, minimum basic requirement of the bacterial growth, Now there is a complex medium. Complex medium means what? So here such for example the blood agar, it has an ingredient that exact components are difficult to estimate. So dear students, sometime you can use the directly blood agar or chocolate agar or any natural product as it is, we can use as a medium for the bacterial culture. So such type of medium known as a complex medium. Okay. Now there is a synthetic or defined medium. So synthetic medium, nothing but the specifically prepared medium from pure chemical substances for research purpose or composition of every component is well known. Whenever we talking about the complex medium, so there is a specific composition of medium is unknown, but whenever we talking about the synthetic medium or defined medium or chemically defined medium, so here each and every composition of the medium is well known, and that's why such type of if you prepared the nutrient medium and the composition well known, so that medium consider as a synthetic medium or defined medium, chemically defined medium. For example, the peptone water in which 1% peptone plus 0.5% NaCl. So this medium or peptone water consider as a synthetic or defined medium. So it is clear that now the complex medium are also known as a natural medium. So complex medium or natural medium in which the composition is unknown. Okay, all miscomposition of every component is unknown, but in synthetic or chemically defined medium, the compositions of every component is well known. Now there is a third type, that is a special medium. Okay, so now that special medium again categorized into the three types: enriched media, selective media, and differential media. So enriched media, nothing but the substances like blood, serum, egg are added to the simple medium and used to grow bacteria that are extracting in their nutritional need. So basically dear students, enriched medium nothing but the medium which allow the group of bacteria, different bacteria can grow in that particular nutrient medium. So that medium known as a enriched media. Okay, so media is supplemented with the substances like blood, serum, egg for the growth of microorganism. Okay, so already we discuss about the simple mediums, right? So in that simple medium, whenever we add blood, serum, egg, so it is considered as a enriched media. And enriched media, and what is difference between the enriched media and enrichment media? So enriched media nothing but the solid nutrient medium supplemented with the blood or serum or egg, that known as a enriched media. For example, blood agar, chocolate agar. And enrichment media nothing but the liquid medium which allow only a single strain of bacteria and inhibit the other strains of bacteria. Such type of nutrient medium known as a enrichment medium. Okay, so you can see here enriched media select for a certain group of microbes, while an enrichment media select for only one microbe. You can see here the pictures of enriched media, right? So this one is the blood agar mediums. Initially we prepared all these three nothing but the blood agar medium. you can see here in the first one there is a Streptococcus pyogenes. Okay, so Streptococcus pyogenes bacteria can grow on the agar medium. On the same agar medium, Escherichia coli also grow. On the same medium, Staphylococcus epidermis also can grow. So same blood agar is allowed to grow the three different types of bacteria, right? And that's why such type of medium known as a enriched medium. Okay, but in this picture you can see this one is the uninoculated, but whenever we inoculated the samples, and in that sample there is so many different types of bacteria, for example the Salmonella, E. coli, Aureus, right? So out of which only this medium, this one is the liquid medium. Okay, already I explained you what is the enrichment medium. Enrichment medium nothing but the liquid medium which allow only the single bacteria, right? So this one is the example of enrichment medium in which we inoculate the sample, and inside the sample there is so many different types of bacteria, but this medium only allow to grow the Salmonella. Okay, so Salmonella bacteria only can grow in the medium, in this liquid medium, and that's why, and other bacteria are inhibited. So that's why this type of medium known as a enrichment medium. Okay, so this one is the for example selenite F broth favor the growth of Salmonella, also prevent the growth of normal competitor like E. coli. Now you can see here this one is the blood agar medium. Already I explained you this one is the blood agar medium and allow the group of bacteria grow on the surface of this nutrient medium. This one is the chocolate agar medium, means nutrient medium supplemented with the chocolate. So this chocolate agar medium contain red blood cells that have been lysed by the slowly heating at 80 degrees Celsius. So whenever you added the antibiotics in the nutrient medium, so that specific antibiotic inhibit the various types of bacteria, okay, and allow only some bacteria to grow on the surface of nutrient medium. We can add the dyes, chemical, specific chemical, or we can alter the pH for the